Hello and welcome to Yeyu Lab. Multi-agent frameworks enable us to build more complex systems by allowing agents to work together, which overcomes the LLM's response limitations like lack of long-term memory or the lower reasoning depths. These advantages are especially useful when you are struggling to build complex applications with limited prompt engineering skills, like the powerful AutoAgent, which specializes in conversational agents and diverse orchestration patterns, and provides a wide range of LLM inference interfaces and tools, and Crew AI, which emphasizes the roles and responsibilities of each agent, enabling agents to function as a cohesive team. However, designing a confirmed agent workflow and context relevance for inter-agent communication is not that easy. Today, I will introduce AgentKit, which is a newly released lightweight multi-agent framework built on the concept of graph and node architecture, providing a more intuitive and flexible approach to designing and implementing complex multi-agent systems. AgentKit confirms the paradigm by presenting multi-agent systems as dynamic graphs where each node represents a specific subtask or knowledge unit. The connections between nodes, called edge, indicate the content relevance of each node to another. This node-centric approach allows for a more intuitive representation of relationships between agents and tasks, unlike the traditional frameworks that depends on explicit agent-to-agent communication or predefined roles. AgentKit utilizes the node dependencies to implicitly instruct the information and action workflow within the system. The whole development of AgentKit started from this paper. Here, they maximized the utility of this graph-based methodology and proved that this approach is quite efficient to their experiment scores. If you are interested in their theory, experiments, and comparison scores with other reasoning frameworks, you can read this paper. So back to the framework itself, the core innovation of this AgentKit framework lies in its graph-based architecture and node dependency mechanism. Understanding that, now we should be more practical and focus back on the application development with AgentKit and leverage its innovative methodologies. So in its implementation, the node is the basic unit of this framework. Each node is associated with a prompt and a set of dependencies which derived from the edge definition. Inside of each node, AgentKit provides a set of building hooks for us to freely construct the flow's context and logic. These hooks including the compose, which pre-processes the input, including adding more DB data for background knowledge, and then the LLM function, which calls the desired LLM API, and after query, which processes the LLM response, for example, the extracting the instructed output with JSON schema. Now let's walk through two examples to see how it works. So the first example is about a story generation workflow. In this example, we will create a graph with several nodes. The graph will start with a node that generates a story idea, followed by a node that develops the idea into a short outline, and then a node that writes a final version of the story. The last node reviews the story with its outline, provides a feedback and a score. To better understand the concept of a dynamic graph, we will also add temporary nodes for story recommendation to certain publications. First, install the AgentKit package. You should note that the AgentKit is a very new software, so I installed it from its working repository for the latest features. So let's use git clone to download the source code. and then install the local version. In the code, we will import AgentKit and provide the OpenAI API key in the environment, and then create a graph instance as a top layer infrastructure. Define the LLM API function that initiates inference of GPT-4 model, which will be used in this AgentKit application. Now we can start to create nodes for our graph. Here we create 4 nodes. Node 1 is generate a story idea. Node 2 is develop the story idea into a short outline. Node 3 is write a short story based on the outline. Node 4 is review the story. Here we define the key, define the prompt for each node to make each node understand what they should do. These are all the static nodes that will always exist in the entire application lifetime. After these nodes created, we can add dependencies, which are called edge, between nodes. You should note that edges are directional from the start node to the end node, meaning the direction of the edge indicates the data flow direction. For example, one edge start from story idea key to outline key means that the content of the story idea will be passed to the outline node to make output of outline, including the context of the story idea. Okay, so here the edges are all static as well. You will see that from the story idea to the outline, and then from the outline to the story key, which is one sequential dependency, but the review node is connected to both outline and story key, means that the review job will consider both story and the outline as the background knowledge. Above is the static part of the graph. Now we will create several temporary nodes as a dynamic part demonstrating the concept of the dynamic graph. We will use the add temporary node to add the first temporary node with the temporary edge to the recommendation node. So in this node, we'll ask the node to recommend this story to the New York Times, and the recommendation should also consider both story and the review as its context. Okay, now we can execute the graph by calling the evaluate method. Let's run it first. So you see that the first agent writes a story idea involving a time traveler and a talking llama from our imported prompt. And then the second agent works out a short outline which aligns with the story idea with the same title, chrono llama, and the context also follows. Then the writing agent writes out a final version with the same title and the same outlines. Then you will see the review of the story has been generated with the reviewing of the story and reviewing of the outline. Right? And then it generated the recommendation to the New York Times with the story and the review comments. Okay, but here you will not see the temporary nodes actually are automatically removed from the graph. So let's prove that by creating another temporary node. Node 6 that also generates recommendation to Washington Post this time. And evaluate again. Let's run. So this time the code will give you two workflow results. One with the New York Times recommendation. And the second workflow finally generated the recommendations to Washington Post. And the recommendation to New York Times has been removed. So that means the dynamic graph is successfully applied. When looking deeper, you will see that the content of each node is pretty much aligned with the context their relevant partner nodes created. Here is a special note for you. At this moment, the current working codebase of the temporary node usage looks locked by the author's design, and I don't know why. To successfully run the code, you need to manually find the evaluate function in the graph pi in the AgentKit source code, and then comment this assert that required the temporary nodes should be cleared before calling evaluate. So I don't know why, but if you comment it, it will not assert here, or the temporary node process will be fine. Now let's move into the second example, which will demonstrate a financial health analysis application. This example is created to demonstrate the simple DB node usage. So we will create a graph with only one node for financial health analysis, and the only focus is to show how to parse the database. It's actually an external knowledge base in structured data into the node. So in the dictionary type of DB, there are several key values inside to represent a company financial status, including the company name, financial metrics with the substructure of revenue, profit margin, and debit to equity. And we will put that DB structure into the node creation process here as one of the parameters to the simple DB node construction. So in the prompt, we will ask the node to analyze the financial health of db.company braced by the dollar, which indicates the corresponding data inside the DB structure. And the revenue financial metrics revenue and margin of financial metrics profit margin, something like that, and provide a brief assessment. Here we should also use the compose prompt DB as a compose function. So we just run this solo node graph to see the output. So from the output, you will see the background knowledge from the DB structure has been successfully passed into the final generation output. You will see the revenue with the 5 billion profit is 15%. So all these placeholder in the prompt has been filled with the actual data. So the AgentKit provides a flexible and intuitive way to build multi-agent applications. After playing with it for a while with this early version, I believe that it has the potential to be one of the most promising frameworks in the field of agent development. That's all for today. For the tutorial and the source code, you can find the link in the description below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Keep innovating, and I'll catch you in the next one.